Hey everyone, this is Nick, and today I'm going to show you how to make this bar chart with a threshold or a trend line on it, but the trend line is actually going to be behind the bars. This isn't something that you would normally do in Excel in terms of the features that they have in the combo chart. That line, if you add a line to your bar charts, it always ends up in front of the bars. You'd think it'd be really easy to sort of swap them and swap the series and put the line behind the bars, but it's a little more involved than that. And this inspiration comes from a blog post by John Peltier over at PeltierTech.com. I'll put his link in the description below. I hope you go check it out. He had kind of a different way of doing this, a little bit more precise and technical way. I'm going to show you kind of a workaround that I really like, and I think it's kind of easy to do this. So if you ever have a time when there are data labels in the bars and you want a threshold or a benchmark line and you don't want the line to go through your labels, this might actually be a pretty good trick to try. So let's go ahead and flip over to my screen right here, and I'm going to show you how to put this benchmark line behind your bars in your bar chart. It's going to look just like this. This is my final product. I'm going to put it over here so that you can see as I walk through. I'm going to highlight my data series here. We're going to insert a chart like we normally would. It's going to be a clustered 2D column chart right here. And what we're going to do is we're first going to put the blue bars, or our actual values, on the secondary axis. So we're going to open up that format data tab and then go to the secondary axis there. And you can see now I have two different axes here. We can actually just get rid of that one. We're going to keep only this secondary one over here. And then what we need to do is we need to find a way to highlight the bars that went behind the threshold line, that line that will end up at 3. So what I need to do is go over here to the Format Data Series, click on Series Options, and then we're going to go to that target value. And now you can see my bars have been highlighted or selected there. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to first select the overlap to 0%, and then what we're going to do is we're going to give a drop shadow effect to these bars. So click on the shadow there, and then you need to make sure it's zero transparency, 100% size, zero blur, and then the angle is actually going to be 270, so that's a custom angle, and then we'll keep the distance at 3. Now you can see that black shadow line appear. That's going to be our benchmark line. What we're going to do is we're going to one by one highlight the orange bars, and we're going to isolate them and select no fill. If you highlight them one by one like this, that allows you to keep your legend intact. So here's our legend here, and you can see that orange is still there. Let's actually go and make sure that the shadow is orange too. Perfect. So there is your line. Now what I could probably do is get rid of my grid lines. Let's just say that I wanted to keep it like this. We'll move the legend up to the top right there. Maybe we can play with the gap width a little bit on those blue bars. Maybe I want to put labels on them. I'll put those outside and let's make them blue. Now that looks pretty nice. Now the only thing you can't really do in this way is label the benchmark line, but you could sort of isolate that bar, click on one label there, and you could just drag your label here like this. Let's get rid of that leader line. We'll just delete it. And so if you had a nice chart like this, I think that could actually work pretty well. So that's a pretty nice little trick there. I hope that you will use it in your work. If you like this video, I hope you give it a thumbs up. Make sure to hit the subscribe button too. Every time you subscribe, every time I post a new video, you can set that little bell notification there to get notified in your YouTube app that I've posted a new video. Hope you have a good day, and I'll see you next time.